Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sounding a bit gloomy today. That's because I've got no credits. You've got no credits, you can't work. I have had that much credit for the last 2 days. No missions, because missions are broken.
For our guests' safety, this station has been designated as an
armed. And if you get a mission, it doesn't work. Well, apparently, I started the game after 5 hours. When a new patch comes out, the first thing I do is...
We advise guests, please use caution on exiting the
armed. Now, this patch seems like the end. One of the worst patches I've ever played. There's no way around this system. I'll try multitasking. As long as I've got nothing to do, better. So, yeah, I'm moving. Well, I will say.
This station is a proud member of the ship share program, encouraging travelers to
nearly 100,000 in about 3 days. Everything's working right. Boom. Server crashes. Boom. Ship disappearing. I can't care. Let's talk about that. Well, we all use the ships are losing credit to crash. That's it. That's only true. Well, I'm an explorer.
A reminder that vehicles left unattended on launch platforms
need to return to storage. I don't want to buy credits to continue to play the ships, to continue the role play. So credits are made in the game, not outside.
To prevent traffic, we ask all arriving pilots to use the designated landing area. Launch platforms are for departing ships.
So find the ship.
You don't
have to.
Save on
resources and expenses. Join
the ship share program today
and fly together. Oh, okay. Now start the question.
Kindly ask that
Jenny get an air on the ship. Okay, as I was saying,
your ship has been delivered to the farming landing pad.
In the safe zone. I don't really go attacking
to access your ground,
because at the end of the day, I don't mind shooting unarmed people on what I'm using, unless I have to. Okay?
For our guests, the station has been designated as an armistice zone. All weapons are currently safe.
I was just looking, I bought my space suit. If I didn't buy my space suit, I would be on here today. I haven't got my siblings or nothing like that on my armor. And it says, I made over 100,000 credits because I am working on the armor since I've been armed. I am trying to play a gameplay on the Levski circuit for the rest of the players in the orb. Yesterday, I was supposed to be doing the Daymar rally. Yeah, didn't do too bad. Couldn't go in there, had no credits, blah, 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 etc. Well, as I was saying, I knew there were bugs, okay, and my job is to work around them. So when I work around them, I tell the rest of the org, don't do this, don't do that. Well, apparently, I'm Omega Todd. Nothing wrong, he's a good guy, nothing to say, unless I take the piss out. He was a bit desperate. He came on here with 400,000 credit, his own money. Okay, not numbered now. He was screaming like a baby. Why? Because he's lost 2/3 of it in this patch here. He's a good player, nothing wrong with him. Okay? He was trying to land at Levski Circuit with his cat. He was trying to land at Levski. I told him not to go there because it's really buggy. Especially when you've got two players, which I'm actually into now to find out these bugs. But he went there, he couldn't land because the doors were open. Okay. So he was worried because he had all this shit on his arm, caterpillar, and he couldn't land it. So I advised him to land within 100 meters away from the landing bay, then at Levski, then go round the back, spawn another ship, and then that will take care of the ship. But somehow he didn't make it. Well, freezer, well, I was going to go and help him out, he got some experience, okay, but somebody else went and helped him. Freezer came and helped him, just about got the ship in the hangar bay. He spawned him one, he took the rest of the day. Because of the bugs. Basically, if you've got cargo and you get trapped in there and you can't get out and you damage your ship, you've got to lose your cargo starts to reason. So obviously you have to find some cargo. Okay. So I went on the search to explore. And get it to the place to play safe. Well, I said to myself, I'm not going to go to port this though. Because it's a load of idiots that like to go pew pew pew. I'm not into pew pew pew, okay?
Hello and welcome aboard your dream
computer. I've got all these space stations and whatnot, and with the exception of Grim Hex, okay? Too small for the ships you want to use. So I thought, well, check out all these with the traded apps, find out what can be made.
Gear up.
I'm going to go to all these bases and see what we can make and whatnot. Because as you know, Levski was dried out, Fortaleza was dried out because it was doing iodine crack, or should we say space food or whatever. There's no money to be made because the economy's gone down. So I was out on the scout. Now I know the server's safe, it is safe, it doesn't crash, and if it does crash, you get your shit back. But to my amazement, I went to Family Farms. You know Family Farms very well. It's got no landing deck. Okay. So I took off from Armpits, that's got a landing deck, and I went straight to Family Farms. Now, nothing wrong, everything's clean. Filled up with shit because I know nothing's going to go wrong because the server is safe. 99.9% safe. Put my cargo on the ship, go back out to give the cargo up, no ship. Okay. You say, so I bought a track and we took a miss. We could miss on the ship. I went on the ship. I told this boat to let's spawn out of the ship. Okay. And I will leave the ship. Oh, we know the ship is supposed to be there. We only got in 30 seconds. She spawns out. I go into Family Fortunes or Family Farms. Come back out. No ship. She's drowning. Everything's lost. So basically, if you're going to be doing cargo runs, do runs where you can land the ship on a landing pad. If you crash, it despawns at least. You can come back and start with your cargo. But there's one big problem. If you buy the cargo from there, you can't send it back. You need to sort that out and sort that out. Because if people want people to start spending money on AUC credits, they're not gonna be happy. Okay? Now let's get back to me. I ain't spending no money again. I've got enough ships there to make money. I can't play. 2 days now I've been playing this game. 2 days. And that's what I've got after 2 days. Can't make no money. As it says, I can go in there all day. I can tell you for money, there's no mission. But to make this game, no mission. And if you do get a mission, it's broken. So how the hell am I going to make money? Do I have to wait until the next patch comes out? In 2 months? Hell no. But I can't make no credit for this. This will crack you up. I've been playing every day for a year, no minimum, less than 6 hours. Getting content, creating gameplay, because I'm not into PvP, blah, blah, blah. I need credits. What am I going to do? I can't make any credits, because there's no gameplay. I'm just flying around the ships, shooting friends. It's going to make it very unpopular. So I'm in two hands here, what to do next. Hey, I've just got a light bulb. Shit, I don't think there's much in it, but at least there is some gameplay until I can get the credits before. Now there's too many things going on in this game, and at the moment this game is boring, really boring. I've been here for all day looking for content to do, but there's one I created called the Levski Circuit. So quite a few actually, but the Levski Circuit is a creator. Going around the track, blah blah blah, doing different types of the person on the track, taking tests so you can become a level 1 vehicle operator, so that's it. And whatnot. Loading and learning the endurance of the ground vehicle. What can do and what cannot do. I know if I took part in the Daymar rally, I would have won, because everybody blew up the ships, I mean the vehicles, but I wouldn't have won. Because at the end of the day, it's how we drive. I'm not an expert, but at the end of the day, you know what I mean. So I'm going to Levski Circuit now, and I'm going to spawn a ship, and I'm going to do 20 laps around the course. Yeah, long and boring, there's nothing to do. I'm not going to make any money, because there's no credits. I can make money on this, but every run I do, I've been lucky if I make one aUEC credit. One aUEC credit. So how long it take me to double that? It would take me at least 1 hour to double that to 1,000. An hour after that to 2,000. Then 4,000. Then 8,000. That's how I play. Okay? And what you're thinking, you don't spend all your money. No, you don't. Like it says at the beginning, you make mistakes. And actually what happened, I was talking to look on this and I pressed the wrong button and I pressed enter and all the credits went to it. But like I said, the game, when it crashes, you can be spawned back in the game, but there's a new bug now, single player or double player. The ship will disappear when you come out, guaranteed. I did notice it 2 weeks ago when they were doing an event. What did they do? I can't remember, some kind of shooting, some kind of shooting, and I was the cameraman basically. I've been here for 10 minutes chatting, and I've not even set course yet. I'm going to set course for Levski. Small ships are okay. Okay, they're okay for landing, but the big ships, so many mistakes, but I got it 60% ironed out. But I won't put credit on there and put people on there to do the mission. We'll do it. So some of you guys out there now, you must be causing havoc with your friends, because there's nothing to do. If you lose your money, there's nothing to do. So you're gonna have to be pure to. But like I said, I thought we were around it. I'm going to have to buy the mining ship, okay? And then after that, I will consider buying the Orion. This is a 2SJ. A 2SJ means I want to go to selling, but I can't go straight. I'm going to sell it. Now, what I was going to say, to go to selling from Port Hollister, it's a two-stop journey, so I call it 2SJ. I used to have a business, you see, and every time we stopped, we called it 1SJ, 2SJ, 3SJ. So keep an idea how long that job will take. So I'm going to be boring the guy in the next 2 hours. doing the same thing over and over and over and over. Well, you guys, I'm not saying you should spend your money on a buying ship, but if you're not into pew 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 like me, okay, and you lose your credits, don't rely on your friends giving you anything, because they're going to give you dog shit. But they are your friends, of course. Okay. I've had to reprogram the joysticks because of the new settings. Modulating shields, let me see if it changes. I'll put it on. I didn't want to get a crime star. But it's supposed to be on. Let's see if it's working. Headphones not in properly.
Modulating shields.
Okay. Modulating shields I've got. I know you think it's stupid because CID didn't create it. Well, if you look down here, alright, you see the shields are modulating. And what that does, as the shields are being knocked down, they're rebuilding themselves. Okay? So it's very difficult for them to knock down the ships, giving you early warning. It does a lot more. I can pump them up, and it does the same thing. As you can see, I can overclock them and they can go up to 400% overclocked. But the good thing about it is, when you overclock the shield, you don't draw any power. As you can see, I'm not using no power on the shield. Basically, what it's doing is taking a percentage from each shield and it builds up the shield that's damaged. Say I'm going to use top shields, as you can see, they're fluctuating, but the main shield is being regenerated all the time. If somebody shoots you behind and you don't see it, it will keep it constant. Okay, but there's also one other benefit to this. You can also reduce your shields so you're not using much power, but I found something else better on this. Going into the shields. This is going to be amazing. I'm going to solve it.
Weapons, power is running low. Engines, power is running low. Attention, system is overheating. Shield system, power is running low. Shield system, power is running low. Shield system, power is running low. Attention, system is overheating. Shield system, power is running low.
Basically, I'm going to try and do it. Okay.
Shield system, power is running low. Engines, power is running low. Attention, system is overheating. Shield system, power is running low.
Just give me a minute. I've not seen this happen before.
Shield system, power is running low. Attention, system is overheating. Attention. Shield system is overheating.
Okay, I've turned everything off. I'm going to try and find the arm shields to give you an example. This is not the right ship to be doing this, but obviously I've not got another ship at the moment.
Is running low. Engines, power is running low. Attention, shield system is overheating.
I don't think I can do that to just testing the ship.
System is overheating. Shield system power is running low. Shield system power is running low. Attention. System is overheating. Shield system power is running low.
Well, basically, what is when you overclock these shields?
Shield system power is running low.
This is cracking me up, this.
Attention. System is overheating. Shield system power is running low. Weapons power is running low. Engines power is running low. Attention. System is overheating.
When you overclock the shields, the power setting stays at 100 all around. It will not go to 150, but it will pull the power when it's needed, giving you extra shield when boosted. So if you need power for the rest of the system, it should work. But it does work, but I'm not doing the shield for anything, so fast it won't be too far.
Attention, shield system is overheating. Attention, shield system is overheating.
It does work. Basically, you could have it 100%. I'll have to do more demonstrations on that, actually. But anyway,
Modulating shields. Modulating shields.
As you can see, so if anybody hits you, you're still going to keep a good percentage. This ship is so fast. If you don't know, I'll tell you what, while I'm here, if it's got the power, look how quick this does not, I say not to 60, okay? Watch how quick this pump builds up. 1300, 1400 in a couple of seconds. That is zippy. That's why I like that, this ship. Now, how I got that, I used boost and I used thrusters at the same time. And it's good that people are shooting at you because you just zip out and you're charging like a ball coming back.
Circuit, but I'm tempted.
Modulating shields. Where have we gone? I've switched to map hunter. So we're set up to do combat this week.
Modulating shields, modulating shields.
So defense is my game. I've missed the money in ships, so I could have some for credits. is what I would need to build up in game. If I can't make difference in game, I'm going to see the alignment. That's me personally. We've got guys in here. Oh gosh, I've got 1,000,000 credits. Blah 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 blah. But what used to is it if you're going to lose it, it costs you money. If we went to bank every 5, every 10 minutes just to get credits out, just to buy cargo or to play things, and that's gonna take away the fun, it's gonna cause stress. Look at Miss, she lost all her money yesterday and I was supposed to give her some. I said hell no, because she won't put me to good news. That'd be teaching what nothing like that. And you know something, I'm still looking for Levski.
Modulating shields.
Your flying is not used this cap. I usually do this swim in a couple of minutes, but today. Shields or the components, things are going to go wrong. So the scanning station at the back, I will stick an engineer there. Talking about that, I actually bought 5 players for the 600i. Okay, we've got 3 in the front that stands to reason. They are the co-pilot, that's the captain, and you've got that. So you've got the captain or commander. Actually he is the commander, he's in command, you know what I mean? You've got the unmanned turret for the front and the unmanned turret for the back. That's replaced automatically. I need 2 more players, 1 for science and 1 for engineering. Now, I actually need 5 players that do 5 different roles, just like Star Trek. Okay? I've got the engineer, I've got the science. Before. 3 and a half, 2 days. Actually, what I wanted to do, I wanted to actually move to Hicks. I was going to move all my ships to Hicks. Reason being, if we break down, I could spawn the ships. I can't spawn those ships there. And that is where I would be my bunk. Because nobody goes there because it's not worth anything. But we actually make a heck of a lot of money this time. I've got to work out who I buy this prospector, and I've got no choice. I don't buy the prospector. I've just got to rely on cargoes, and that can't be done. Because it's so easy to lose money in this game. And I'm glad I've realised this now for when the game starts, to be prepared. Cargo is itchy. There's no guarantees that you can keep your cargo, you are going to lose it. But at the end of the day, I don't really agree you have to be killing somebody to get credit. And CIG has got a flawless system when it comes to mission. So that kills the game automatically. Like I said, while I'm here, I will show you the Levski circuit if it works. It's a bit dark. Where I can. There's actually 2 outside landing pads at Levski. I only need 1. I want to investigate, explore the other one, but I'll have use for that. Okay, Levski course, there's actually checkpoints on here too. This is the Levski course. If you look at the crosshair, you can follow it around. Okay, now as you can see, it is a circuit. And we did, because it's a circuit, you can actually create quite a number of different tasks and make money out of it, which I'm not going to go into. But like I said the other day, you're not traveling miles from security, safety, you can get back home if something goes wrong. So that's the Levski circuit. Now, I've been asked to create training for the orgs that I made. Now, this one here, when I do this test, I'll be doing 20 laps around the Levski circuit with whatever means I can. When I've done 20 laps around the circuit, I will get a level 1 vehicle 1 star. You do 5 stars, but I've got to create missions to go on. Trader, I'm actually a 3-star trader in the game. Pilot, I'm a 1-star. That's my 1-star. But trading, I'm actually a 3-star. Explorer, I'm a 2-star. Okay, because I've actually created content that's not in the game that gives it a role play. Now, I will put these missions up, okay, for the trade, because there's a lot of players that come in here that can't play. Okay, and you can't do the basics like take off a plane or go to or clear the crime stat. I do them all day. Around the circuit, can I do it? That is going to be seen. Something like it is, isn't it? big ships have, any ship that can't see on the, this is the way to land, but that's not the proper way. You need a navigator to talk, you need to keep it real. Say you've got problems landing in Levski, it's not the small ship that's the problem, it's the big ships, okay? Until you sort the bugs out. Disagree with what I'm saying, but I usually play with two players, okay? When you guys start learning, you have to learn to play with one player, but with two players, it's a whole different game. Bugs and everything. The bugs are different. You've got to work your way around it if you want to gameplay. I'm going to take the side road now. Because bits of all of that, so I'm working on that. I'm actually trying to work on the shields at the moment, and I want to use them as dampeners, but I call them stabilized. We can't really say shields at the moment, because in our time, it's not really stabilized, just sticking suspension or whatever, but something to keep that bloody buggy. Only love that loose with squeal. If I can do 20 laps on this, I've got it cracked. I can do it over, no problem. But like I said, it's exploring. I am an explorer in the game and an engineer. Exploring doesn't mean they create contents in the game. You can create your own contents, okay? I had a joystick, I had a steering wheel for this, but it's not connected up, so I've been using a joystick.
Toggle land systems. System check.
I was saying yesterday, a few days back, we need a speedometer. That's the speedometer. And that's the compass, the radar. Trying to get the arm compass side out. I need some steering. I am in 4K SLI, okay, and it's not working properly. But what you notice is the richness of the colours. Most of you won't be able to see it, the quality, you can see the colours, how rich it is. Every time I do like a rocket pass, I won't use a jet because I always seem to miss it. Stay on the course and don't want no damage to you too. capabilities, you can message the Copilot and the Navigator, and you've got to do the daemon allowing. So we need to think for like this to make our own content. So, right now. That's impossible. So you can see there's that beacon, that's one lap. And look at this intact. So you can create what race you want, blind light caution. It's easy to really see. You can necessarily create any kind of race you want. You can do a rally, you can do relays. You know what I mean? And the pit stops. There's a circuit, isn't it? Are you still in contact with the ball? Whoa! I know you guys want some exciting, but I want my level one in, I want my level one vehicle's license. One star. That will be my potential when I'm driving for the people because I've done so much and yes, I'm okay at it. There's 5 stars you get, but everyone is a basic. And that's just driving without recognition. Now, oh, like that. Oh, that's really interesting. Drive off it if you want, then you're going to see the damages. Think it will be okay. No different. Even if you start the game, then it will be. Even at this slow pace, it's still fast to move over. Something you're gonna lose something. As you can see. I will run out of oxygen before I let this sleep. Thank you. it will take you off the road. It will tip or whatever. The boat is still got its wheels. And I'm a bit bumpy, so I'm going to drop the speed. You guys have been doing my rally. It's not about tear arsing down the road because you're walking. Simple as that. You're not using your oxygen because you're not moving. And the confidence gets better, you can go faster if you don't need to. Because even at this speed, believe it or not, you are still travelling faster than the rover. The rover's at a good time. I can actually go flat out, but... I think to you guys, you can drive outside though, okay, without wrecking. You can do the day by rally. And you can keep all your rules. As the confidence builds up, you start going faster. You know, you will be stopped. Okay? If I'm still here, well then you know. It's a little bit difficult talking to you, trying to remember this course. But I think the guys are going to use this course just for next week, because I found out that the vehicles have got some fun in that book and shoot everybody. All it takes is practice. You guys don't want to practice. I'm not going out in the side road because bits fall off. Excuse me. I ain't lost no bits. Whoa, which way? I'm going to hit him up. That to the right is the right way. To the left, you can't overtake. You head up, you can overtake here, but it's rough terrain. You still can head him up in the pass. I'm going to go slow because I don't want to get the vehicle up. 17 laps to do. That's where he will be coming out, and normally I would say blind right caution. Take that as it now, because the course is right there. See, it's got its own little things in there. Thank you. had to book a cyclone and crashed it by now. Nearly everyone is. Okay? This is a test to show you it can be done. If you try this at home, you'll see. The gameplay is not in there by CIG, but it's there for you to create your own content and have more fun. Vehicle there, so if you're running short on oxygen, you could get the oxygen, but actually you've got 1.5 hours oxygen on you and you won't even use it because you actually need the vehicle. So oxygen not depleted. If you're going to do a rally, make sure you travel right. You have to travel right. Reason being, if you break the vehicle, you need to come back up. That's enough oxygen to run down this circuit Levski at least once. Working the key binding as a code. if you had a navigator, your navigator would be inside here, and what that navigator would be doing, he'd be looking at all your instruments, okay, and making sure everything's okay, and also checking his compass and everything. You as a pilot, because the visibility is bad, I mean, the driver, you have to drive this way. I know it's not the way to do it, but until CIG works out the high level by raising the man a couple more inches, or lowering it. Actually look around, but my key binding has not been sorted. Okay, let's try that then. Look up, let's try that. Definitely fast in the road. to the prospect, because when you can get things in game, the prospect is your big base to start off. This game is about credits. The ships are there to entice you to play the game. Which is your life ship. Off a bit, so you guys just bear with me. I'm not built like Mike Tyson, you see. I've actually lost count of all the laps. I'm going to put about 600 now in the one vehicle. Now you can tear ass down the road, you can do 5, 10, 15 laps. Watch the vehicle, we've been walking without the brakes. We don't want to get the first couple of laps of the building. So I'm going to tear out. The gameplay for these land vehicles won't be like this, it's at its beginning stages. If you play the car games, you'll have an idea of what it's going to be. It's going to have everything in there. I'm not into pew pew pew. You don't have to see me in there. So because most guys in our off, or their off, I actually sit back and do the stream because I don't really want to shoot. And they make a rule there now, if you're on there, don't shoot me because I'll just walk off. And these games you can connect with. So you can have to do formation is from the concentration. Hard left. Gosh. The reason I say that, because I always see that beacon. If I don't see that beacon, that person's going to go up there. Because we do realise it, you're going too fast. If you are going too fast, you're going to hit that rock. That's why. Hard left is caution. He's going the wrong way. Day before, she provides a great team of attendees, but the amount that I lost, I'm not going to go spend money to put in the game. Yes, I did someone say you get it back every quarter, think about when the game starts, it's not on. That's my point, I spent enough money in the game, and I enjoy it, you know what I mean? I don't want to be selling my ships, to be buying credits, to be losing when the game crashes. And someone say, oh, they're soft, oh, now, ladies, you don't know that. Because I'm not going to be with a pipe plan, about a free plan, and it's going to be. But I'm very reluctant at the moment because we're going to have. You'll notice I'm up in the controls. You see me there moving around? That is me, that is my eyes, and I'm using the mouse. The mouse is my eyes, and I look around. Steering, I use a joystick, I use twist. Okay? When I want to go forward or backwards, now you should already know this, but for new players, just look at it. Your mouse is your eyes, okay? Your mouse is your eyes. Your steering is your twist, like on a car. And because I'm using joystick, when you put your foot down on your gas, you push backwards and push backwards. So it all can be done with single control. Reason why I'm not using our CIG's configuration. The reason being because of conflict with the flight. I've got this worked out from the top of it. I will be giving these things to the guys in the OR. I don't really, I'm used to my way. I'll look at this with the same. No, seriously. When she first started, she was on the keyboard. Then she got one joystick. Then she got your second joystick. And right, excuse me, needs where to play, because at the end of the day, it's two joysticks. You can't use one hand on your right hand. Your joystick needs to learn how to play. Now she swears right hand, and she's not the two, because she's supposed to learn to use two joysticks. Guarantee I am going to pass one. I do a lot of slow stop starts because I'm still learning. As you can notice, I've tried to stay on the track. And I've got, yes, it can be done on dirt track, but that will become the experience and speed. Every track on the bar now, just keep bouncing all over the place. It's so burnt that way, so that's going to do. Okay! My vehicle's license for the level one vehicle operator, I have to go down this course 20 times. And it's not just this, because I've obviously created for level 2, level 3. I'm also doing one for vehicle, cargo. I'm level 3 cargo all of my rights. I'm going to make so many different types of missions. I have to get your missions in the context of the game, you see. I don't actually follow CIGs. Because look, they change it, they take it away. You know what I mean? You can actually make money from this. It's going to be a good future for you. It depends on this. Right, said you're looking for your people, but you've got to get more. You want to find things to do. Create your content. You can stream it. GOT likes it. They'll put in their roles in patches to come. And they are going to be developing a lot of race ideas, so they really do need to come up with them. But they won't need to actually. Because there's so much you can do now, as long as they've got the idea what they can do. They've got diversity in contracts and in tracks, there's no limitation. Yes, cycle. How many cycles? How many options? Let's see. Right. Okay. I've used half of it and I've done 10 laps. Basically, I might have to cut the lap down to 10. The whole idea not to get oxygen. Because most of you guys don't usually have a double player, and this way you can actually use it to do on your own. Most submissions I create are usually for two players, because this is where the game's going. The best will follow on automatically. The reason why I'm saying two players, because when you've got two players, it creates a whole new set of bugs and compliances. So you have to work around it to continue the gameplay. And it's really, really hard because you've got to remember them. And then you get people telling you, no, this isn't good, this. You say to them, have you tried it? And you say one thing to them, start calling the retard. You don't want to know. Because they know more than you. I sit down there 10 hours, 18 hours, they play this game. At the moment, I can't do nothing, I've got no credits. But if you create this one, I don't think I'll be into it. There's lots more that I can do. You see somebody die? You take size 5 guns, I won't say which they are, but take size 5. I strongly recommend going double size. And it's got more coverage on gimbal than the constellation. You can only get the gimbal weapons from the constellation unless you buy them. And I would say that the turrets were size 4s, they're not, because CIG's now locked it down, it's size 3s. Well, it's been forever. As you can see, I've done over 10 laps in this.
Okay!
Whoa! Take off the eyes, the mouse, and the joystick, but it can be done. I will explain that in I have to tell you, these guys are out there, intelligent, you've got to work. Sometimes you have to work out yourself, or how to get into the game. Pick up this, you've been fine 6 months, and she still can't yet. Okay, good actually. Okay. that out because I have to do 20 laps to get my level 1 license. With that, vehicle license, with that, I can turn around and say, I've got level 1 vehicle license. If I've got any roles, I know I will get that book in the level 1. Level 1 is not that much, but it's a lot better than what some of you guys have got. It's all freehand because that's just the mouse, but I think it's a bit too long. This is where VR helps. I will say 10 laps. I do a couple more just to make sure, and then I will stay officially. I have a 1-star vehicle operator. And I'm giving the cyclone 10 laps or so many kilometers. Freezer, he actually crashed there, and so did Dickel Mace. If you watched the last two videos, Dickel Mace crashed. Both crashes, when they come around that bend, they lose control. They come this crash there, and I think Freezer crossed there at the same place there too. Now, if I can get the vehicle back on track. No, that's not going to happen. That's gone. And that would be easier if happened in the Rover 2, because look at this crash in the Rover. If you look at it, as you can see, it was still operational. There's no way I can tip that back the right way around. Talking to you, that would have been okay. I'm at, I've done 10 laps. I have to go around and count it. I have to go watch it all again and see if I've done 10 laps. Which I actually have. I don't think 20 laps would work. 10 laps, yeah. If you're doing the Levski circuit or anything like that, always make sure you address right. No guns, no nothing. Very light spacesuit. Okay? Because when you're running, you're going to be consuming energy. I've got no test point. If I've done the 10 laps, we're counting. 20 laps is too much, you need damn oxygen. At least one lap, I think. I'm gonna try one lap just to prove to you guys it can, you can do one lap. There's a beacon. I've got 25 minutes. If I turn left, that puts you back to Levski. Same applies, if you run over rough terrain, you're going to use rough oxygen to keep it smooth. Also, as you can see, look at my heartbeat, we will not go over 50. If I had anything else, I'd be looking over 100. So I'm going to go round the full course again on foot. This so difficult is because I've got nobody to work with, you see, so I've got to do it on my own, so these contents take ages to create. For instance, I was putting six rovers into the Starfarer. That took me 6 hours. Yeah, I know, I'm mad. No, but I was creating gameplay, you see, and it can be boring. They're asking six people, that will take 5 minutes. And that made the reason being because the vehicles had to be transported to a race to be used. And at the moment, the biggest one out there is the Starfarer until the Hercules comes out. I didn't have a gameplay for the Hercules, but I do now. Remember, I'm not into pew pew pew, okay? I'm into trading and exploration. I'm also an engineer. That's my gameplay. Yes, I can shoot and I can do defense. You know what I mean? So basically, engineer, I can man the shields. I've got modulating shields. So anybody who has me, you know your ship's going to be strong. Okay? What's the strongest ship in the verse at the moment? Forget about the Claymore. Okay? Forget about the Claymore. The Caterpillar is the strongest ship out there. Yesterday, or 2 days ago, I wasn't paying attention. I don't know. But it was quite a decent ship. For 20 minutes, he was shooting at that caterpillar. Now, if I didn't have my shields, which I'd invented, I know I would have got shot down. But I was so confident, I had a full crate of cargo on there. See, look at my oxygen level, look at my heartbeats. You need to keep it as low as you can. It's not, it's like a man when you're doing 20, like you run slower, but you get there. this would be boring if you're on your own, I agree, but I'm trying to create content. But when you start doing it with your teammate, it's better than pew pew pew. It's something different. But the CIT has not created the contents yet, obviously. There is no gameplay at the moment. The missions are all down. If we've got credits, we've got a problem. But at the moment, there's no point in me trying to make credits at this point. If I have the copper raised down, up, I could use that to get back some sort of credits or whatever. But nothing works in the game. And I'm going to show you again. Watch. You know how long I've been here? See what's happening? The players are not doing the missions. They're snapping the missions up and they're not playing them. Okay? Because they know there's no missions. So they can store them, but when their PC crashes, that's when it gets hard. But, okay. Did somebody say go on to the server? If you build up a reputation on the server, it's not wise to change. Why? Because you know that server works. Okay, I'm in the UK. I will not take all my credits and go on to the Australian server. Okay? Because I know someone's going to go. That's giving me an idea. So if you find a server that works, you don't need to change over. Okay? But this is a problem you've got. I'm halfway around the course now. You can see where I crash, I'll pass my vehicle and I'll just run in. I could do two laps like this because I'm not used to having no oxygen. Marathon, that's what it's called. Marathon. Just bear with me 1 second, I'll be back there. Don't listen. I need to change these key bindings because I can run. I think I'll use the throttle. Because it might probably burst. Am I going the wrong way? Oh, you see, I told my mind up for a couple of minutes, I'm not too sure. And it's actually hard on foot because although it's the same track, it's different. Why? Because it takes you longer, you see that. I should have got there by now. I should have got there, but I'm on foot. The oxygen will go down, okay, but I'm not doing no sprint and I'm as light as possible. I will watch this race again, and if I have done 10 laps, I will officially state a level 1 star vehicle operator. Nothing broke on the vehicle, so I would have actually finished it. But because I was talking to you guys, as you can see what happened, it's there in black and white. But there's no exceptions. I choose Levski, it's a safe zone, so they can't really shoot you, so you can get some gameplay without worrying about being shot. You guys are only doing it because they're bored and they're frustrated, and that's the way to take it out. As you get experience, they won't be a problem, because you're learning new things all the time. Careful when you're stripping your armor, you must keep your helmet on. There's a beacon, and you should see my vehicle on the left. I think. No, it's not. I think I used 7 minutes of oxygen. Oh, yeah, there it is. No, it's not. Yes, it is. Sit down for the next 2 months with nothing to do, so I will buy the prospector. companionship just to get basic credit so I could get back to work, because I am an explorer and you need finances to explore. You don't need much, but you need finances to explore. Why? Because I'm exploring cargo, how it depletes, how it gets up, and how it works at different stations. I mean, at the cargo, I wouldn't have known that ships disappear. That goes through the back way, we don't want to go that way. I think I used roughly about 10 minutes of oxygen on this, or just over. You think I should try one more course? In a straight line, don't keep going fast, slow. Just walk consistently. 16 minutes that took me. I'm sure I used about 10 minutes. It took me 10 minutes to go around that course. I am running on the hard surface. If you turn left at Levski, there's a ditch there where you sink. It's like quicksand to me. I'm not going to go down it, but I'll try to remember and I'll go in and I'll show it to you. It's like dragging your feet in a load of mud. Counts at this level now. Every drop of oxygen will. See, that's quicksand, I'm off the track. I don't want to waste energy. Try and stay on this track. I know it's pointless, but trust me on this. when CIG works it out, they will be putting variables on them dirt tracks to give wear and tear. And I would agree with that. Oh, there's no point in having a track at the end of the day. It's for you to learn it and learn the best course on what you can and cannot do. Around the course. I don't need to show you the quicksand because I've just done one just now. And all I did was press space bar. But around the corner, you park your vehicles, you can't, the space bar doesn't work because it's like quicksand. All those variables create drag. It's like 2 tons on your feet. Strain on your feet, oh that's all gravel. Strain on your feet. You can use wearing soft shoes. Every step you take over, you can actually feel every rock underneath. Very smooth. As you can see, I'm not using any oxygen because I'm staying on the path. You can see my heartbeat stays steady. I'm not going to go for a sprint, I'm not going to do it because I know what will happen. It's up to you to work out the course and how you're going to travel. The mistake I made just now is because I was talking to you guys and I wasn't actually paying attention and I went down hard bend. I did give you a caution but I just slipped for a couple of seconds. Tip. I don't usually tip it like that. If I've done 10 laps in the vehicle, I have my level 1 license. I won't know that until I actually do the replay. Guys, I think abusing the Nox, it defeats the object. Because that's also part, you can also fight using flying stuff in there, which you need to be able to do land vehicle controls, learn to different terrains, fast and slow. Also working out your oxygen, how much you've got, all that's in the test there too, as you can see. There's a beacon for home, you see the flame? I actually done this one in better time actually. Terminator of oxygen there. Say 100, it'll be okay, but with the cleave, I'll just slow down. So it brings down the oxygen. I'm on rough terrain here. Can you see all the bits on the floor? I'm almost home. So yes, there is enough oxygen in there for a gameplay to create a mission. It's how you use it at the end of the day. say, look, 10 laps around this because you get so much credit. That doesn't work. This a boring video, but if you understand the contents of this video, there's a lot more to it than just running around the track. It does take a bit of skill. Who says it don't take skill? Did you survive? Did you make it? Did you create 10 laps? Did your wheels drop off? Okay, don't tell me no bullshit. I spent hours doing tactical things like this. I spent 5 grand on this, but I spent 15 actually, but that's what I did. What I'm trying to say, I created a game for myself in here when there's nothing. Can't do any harm, can't get no credits, but I can, not 500. 9 meters of oxygen left. I am running in 4K SLI and I'm not overclocked, I've done nothing to it. This is enough. When I've worked out how to run 3-star citizens on one PC, This PC is pretty powerful. I just don't know how to run three games on here at the moment. One for me, one for my friend, and one for to keep the ship alive when I go to bed at night. The PC doesn't break down, but the game does. But as time goes by, they'll sort all that out. It's a beacon for home, I see it. I hope. A piece of oxygen. Now it's going to get exciting. Kilometers, I mean meters. Thank you. secret, you have to travel light. Unless you're in combat, you've got to change up, obviously. Don't have any guns on, don't have anything on. Travel light. Quicksand. I call it quicksand, okay? Because you actually sink into the ground. And it does that a lot of oxygen. You see? I'm not on the ground, I'm running on the surface. I'm going to keep your player character on the surface. Remember, I've always been going right to complete the course or the circuit. I'm now going to go left. Not just yet. That is pole. But I just want to do a quick demonstration. I've got 6 minutes of oxygen. I think it's round about here. I'm not going on the lap again. I'm just going to try and show you the quick sign. Now that is good for gameplay. I call that quicksand. Your oxygen will diminish because your feet feel like lead. Good job. And full sand. Call it quicksand. Where's your oxygen? It takes explorers like me to know these things, okay? I am an explorer. They've not created nothing in the game for exploration. But this is exploring. What do you see? Shithead! You need a license! Can't you drive? I wouldn't have been as my co-pilot. He ran me over. How much oxygen I've got left? 5 minutes. I could have died. I've got 4 minutes of oxygen. The only way I get credits is if I buy the prospect. It's a prospect to the mining ship. That's the only way. So I won't have to worry about daft figures like that. That's not worth anything. If you get that low, you've got no mission, you have to go and someone donate and you're not going to do it. And now you're too proud to last. You see nothing. Missions will come up, but they're broken. Video's almost to an end, okay? The credits I was making was not to become this and get the credits. credits to create content for the gameplay, but I can't do nothing until the next patch comes out, unless I buy a prospect. You see the option now start going on. Levski twice, okay? Oh, hope this video helped you guys, but seriously, take a look at Leslie's circuit. Okay? It can create a lot of fun just on that circuit alone. Relay races, two-man races, all sorts. Keeps your own challenges. And it's not just Leslie's circuit, there are other circuits out there. Okay? But that one's the easiest for beginners. Can't I see that check? Well, I'm going to go now, okay, you guys?